Hello and welcome back to AmbiV. I'm Casper, and today we're going to take a look at a new pulley system for the 1967 Mustang. There really isn't anything to unbox in the CVF Racing pulley kit. It's simply a giant box full of smaller boxes, and every single component has its own box labeled what it is. In my case, I got a crank pulley, water pump pulley, alternator pulley, and power steering pulley, specifically for the power steering from the 289. Now, this power steering pump requires a press-on pulley, so I had to buy a kit to remove and press on the new pulley, and unfortunately, the kit doesn't seem to exactly fit this power steering pump, but it worked for the purposes. I was able to barely get off the old pulley, and then using this installer press, I got just enough threading on the center shaft to press on the new pulley as far as I could. Once we got the power steering in the car, we found out that the belt was either too short or something is wrong in the instructions for the rear mount of the assembly. The rear of the power steering pump has a slide adjuster, and that was completely maxed out well before we could get the belt on. And ultimately, we had to remove the bolt from that again to get the belt on the power steering pump, and the only place I could find to mount it was a different 3/8 hole in the head that was farther inboard. Now, that works in our case here, but I don't know why that's an issue. I don't know if the instructions are wrong or the belt I was sent was wrong, but ultimately we were eventually able to get this on there after a lot of swearing. The alternator went on much easier. The alternator was basically a bolt-in affair minus the lower tensioning adapter interfering with the clamp on the lower radiator hose. After I swapped out the clamp for a worm gear clamp that was smaller and lower profile, we were able to get it all working and tension that belt successfully. With everything installed, it definitely looks like a much more quality unit than what you would see in a V-belt setup. The machining is very nice, the finish is very nice, and on the engine, it definitely makes it look a lot nicer. There's no squeaks so far that I can determine, as I've just started to break in the engine, and I'll show you that in the next video. So thank you all for watching, and I'll see you next time.